Hi, my name's Dan Keane. I'm a composer, producer, and musician based in London. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you're all doing well. Today, I'm quite excited because I haven't had to prepare anything for making this video. I can just set up my cameras, set up my lights, and talk, which is really exciting because today we're talking about my desk setup. Every single month, I get messages, DMs, emails. What's that control surface? What SSD dock would you recommend? What interface do you use? And to be honest, I've just had enough. I want this to be the video that I send people when they ask those questions. So I thought I would just show my setup that has seen me through every demo, teaser, and trailer for Spitfire, every track on this new album, this Christmas album I've done for Gary Barlow, countless short films, little YouTube videos that I make for myself, and a lot in between. This is my setup. Now, it might seem strange to be talking about the desk setup of 2021 in November as we come to the end of the year. But the reason that I'm talking about it today is because this week marks a year since I moved into this space here in London. And Christian calls it Kaizen. It's a Japanese word for this sort of iterative improvements that you make over time. This feels like a really substantial setup for me now. A setup that has taken a little while to get there. You may have noticed I've invested in new bits of gear over time, but I'm really, really proud of this setup, and I feel like it's time now that I can show you everything that is on my desk, everything that I use every single day, starting with the first thing that's about to leave, actually, and that is my computer. I use a 2018 Mac Mini, the Intel version. It's got 64 gigabytes of RAM, a 3.2 gigahertz, 6-core i7 processor. Now, this computer has been an absolute workhorse for me. It's been fantastic. But as I said in my last video about the new MacBook Pro that I've just ordered, the Mac Mini just doesn't have great graphics performance. And unfortunately, when I'm running a 4K screen, it's just not keeping up. So this is actually going to become my at-home studio rig. But soon, I will have my new MacBook Pro, the 14-inch MacBook Pro, and that will take its place, which I'm very excited about. Connected to it, we've got an LG monitor. This is a 27-inch 4K display, and it is beautiful. You can adjust the height, you can change the angle. It's got multiple HDMI and DisplayPort inputs. It's really fantastic. This was kindly given to me by Spitfire for my use there. I have to film 4K screen recordings. So to be able to have a screen that is 4K is just fantastic. And to be honest, I never realized before working with Spitfire just how much of an increase 4K was over 1080p. But now whenever I look at a 1080p monitor, I just think, I don't know how I survived for so long. Because when you're looking at something all day, every day, It's got to look nice, and I think this is worth the money. Now, above this, I have my Logitech 1080p webcam, and this is fantastic for my general kind of day-to-day Zoom calls and things like that. I have quite a lot of meetings with Spitfire Audio, but just below it is a really fantastic light from Benk Lighting. This is the screen bar. Now, if I just demonstrate with this second camera, if I turn it on and off, you can see that it floods the keyboard with light, but it doesn't add any glare to the screen. And this works really, really well. You can adjust the color, you can adjust the brightness of the light, and it also has an ambient sensor above, so it can change the light automatically depending on your ambient environment. Now for audio, and I guess we should probably talk about my interface first, I'm using a UAD Apollo Twin X, and this has been really brilliant. I've been a relatively recent UAD convert, and the preamps sound fantastic, the plugins are best in class, and I find that this has all the ins and outs that I need for my outboard setup, which we'll talk about in a moment. Connected to it is this microphone that you're listening to now. This is the Townsend Labs L22 Sphere, and this uses a UAD plugin to emulate lots of different microphones, and that was actually the reason that I got the interface. I'm actually an endorsee for Townsend Labs, so they gave me this microphone for free because I love it so much. Basically, it's got two capsules, one on each side, and this means that it can create a 3D image of the various polar patterns that it's emulating. So right now you're listening to it being committed straight out of my UAD console, straight into Pro Tools to record, and so I don't really have to do too much on the back end of the recording, but I get a beautiful U47 emulation on the way in, which is fantastic. But if I were to record someone and I could only have one microphone with me, I'd probably just take this, because if I'm working with a vocalist or something like that, I could choose later between an SM7B or a U87 or whatever. There are loads of different microphones to choose from. And because you can either commit to it early or change things around in the plugin afterwards, it's just so versatile, and for the cost, you know, it's a lot cheaper than the microphones that it's emulating. Now, on the right of my system here, I've got a 6U rack. This is from studiorex.co.uk, and it's really beautiful. This is a walnut one. At the very top, I've got my Blackmagic dock. This is where all of my SSDs are stored. So currently I have 2 4-terabyte drives, and this is for my Spitfire libraries and also for my YouTube videos as well. So basically I run all of my sample libraries off these drives, and then that connects via a single USB-C cable to my Mac Mini, or soon to be MacBook Pro, and it works absolutely effortlessly. I mean, it's basically a glorified cable, so it is quite expensive for what it is, but you can get 16 terabytes in total on one of these docks, and so far it hasn't crashed on me at all. And then just below this, I'm working on quite an exciting new project at the moment, which requires some digital reverbs. So I'm experimenting with the Lexicon PCM70. Now, this has only a mono input, but it has a beautiful stereo output. And when you're running things like drums or synths through it, it just sounds amazing. I've been really having a lot of fun with it. So I'm using the gated plate setting at the moment, 5.2, and I've kind of modified it a little bit so it sounds just right for me. Then next down, I've got the Chandler Limiter Germanium. This is really good for when you're doing DI basses and DI guitars, things like that. It just has a fantastically warm tone to it, but you can also really drive it hard. So sometimes I'll even just take MIDI bass out of my Logic projects and put it through that just to give it a little bit extra something something. And then below it, I've got the DBX 160 compressor, which really just smashes anything. It's particularly good with drums. And again, if I'm running MIDI drums or live loops, things like that, I'll just run it through, compress it a little bit, kind of 2 to 5 dB if I want to give it a nice bit of parallel compression, and then back in. And it just adds a little bit of life that you couldn't have got otherwise. So then all of these run through my Focusrite Octopre Mark II Dynamic. And I've had this thing for years. I used to use it with my old Sapphire Pro 40. This is an ADAT interface, so it connects via digital output straight into my Apollo. Most of the time, I'm just using this thing to add a little bit of interest. But there's so many great plugins these days that I don't actually find very much use for taking stuff out of the box until right at the very end of the process. Now, you may have noticed that I don't actually have any speakers in here. The reason for that is not because I don't like speakers, I love speakers. It's mainly because this room just isn't acoustically treated to be used as a studio environment. So I use headphones all of the time, and then I reference with my mixes downstairs in other rooms. So I use these Beyer Dynamic DT990 Pros. These are the 250 ohm versions. Now, I used to have the 770s, which I still use at home. They're closed backs. These are open back headphones, so they're not great if you're on a train or something. People can hear the music that you're listening to. But they sound so much better than the 770s, at least to my ears. These just sound absolutely brilliant. I use the Sound ID reference software by Sonarworks, which has its quirks, but it means that I can listen to this with a relatively flat frequency response. Mixes just tend to translate really well. Now, for my MIDI keyboard, I used to use a massive 88 key keyboard. In fact, I've still got my M-Audio Oxygen 88 at home. But here in the studio, I just find that most of the time I'm programming individual lines where I don't need full access to every note. So this actually works brilliantly for me. This is the M-Audio Axiom 49, and it's a 49 key keyboard. It's not fully weighted. It's not the best keyboard in the world, but it was something that was available to me here. And I don't know, I just really like it. It just seems to work really well for me. So that's what that is. And then I have it connected to this, the fader box. I get questions about this more than anything else in the world, and I feel really sorry for the guy who created it, because he's just this small creator who had an idea and wanted to share it with me, and he's now just been inundated with orders, and I don't think he can keep up currently. This thing is brilliant. I mean, it's everything that I ever wanted. I know you can do more, and I know with MIDI 2.0 it's not going to be ideal because it's only got MIDI CC output. But it's exactly what I need, and I can take this in a bag with me and use it anywhere. It's just 4 faders. I use CC1 for the mod wheel, 21 for vibrato for Spitfire, CC11 for expression, and CC7 for track volume. That's basically all I need most of the time. Now this and my other USB peripherals are plugged into a single 7-port Anker powered hub, and I'd really recommend a powered hub if you're using SSDs and things like that, because they draw quite a lot of power and you'll find that the bus on your computer won't be powerful enough for it. I learned that the hard way, had lots of things plugged in and then hard drives kept disconnecting and things like that. So if you're going to use one hub, I'd recommend a powered one. This is great. It's got 7 ports for data transfer and 3 for power, so I can have my phone charger plugged in at the same time. And this gives me enough ports to have things like my iLock and my Steinberg e-licensor plugged in so that I can use that with Dorico, which is my notation software of choice. Next to it, I have this hard drive. This is a Western Digital 12 terabyte backup drive, and I use this just as a Time Machine backup for my computer. So I'm going to need to get another one soon for when my new MacBook Pro arrives. But to have a daily or hourly backup of your computer, I think, is absolutely essential, especially when you're working on lots of projects with clients and things like that. For my keyboard and mouse, I use an Apple full-sized Magic Keyboard. So this has got the numerical keyboard at the side, and this is kind of essential for me with the work that I do on Pro Tools and also Dorico. And for my mouse, I used to be a Magic Mouse guy, but I'm actually a convert now to the Logitech MX Master 3 for Mac. And the reason for this is twofold. Number one, my Mac Mini doesn't have very good Bluetooth reception. And so ironically, my Magic Mouse just kept on disconnecting. The second reason was that the charging was just so stupid. I understand why the port's on the bottom, but if you're in a pinch and you need to use your computer while the mouse is charging, I don't want to have to. That was just silly. So this is brilliant. It's got multiple buttons that you can map for different applications, and it's got a single USB-C port at the front, so I can use it with a cable plugged in, and it works most of the time. Generally, I found it to be really ergonomic, and that seems to be good, but I guess only if you're using it in your right hand, so that's something to note. And to be honest, I think that's actually everything on my desk. I guess the only other thing to mention is my other lighting. I cannot remember for the life of me what this softbox light is, so I'll leave it linked down below. And as for these two cameras, these are the Panasonic GH5s, very kindly given to me by Spitfire Audio. Obviously, I need to shoot things like playthroughs, and I often do that here. These are currently on stock lenses, but I have a beautiful Sigma 18-35mm lens, which I'm about to start using on these Panasonics with a Metabones adapter, which I think is arriving tomorrow. So the next video should look very, very crispy if all goes to plan. That's about it, really. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't done already. Loads of exciting things coming soon. I've planned every video between now and the end of the year, and next week is going to be a really good one, so look out for that. Take care, stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Goodbye.